Hello, YouTube, you beautiful person, you.
Yeah, the person standing right there.
Right behind the screen right there.
Bob, Max, Abby, Ashley, Tyler, Bree, Haley, insert random name here.
Yeah, I see you. Now, I'm really excited for the new horror movies coming out, such as The Rings, The Bye Bye Man, Amityville, It Was Being Remade. Oh my God, they're making another Alien movie, yes! So many more. But you can already guess this, but I'm really into getting scared. And which is a big step forward from where I started because I'm a winner. I think playing horror games for YouTube really changed my adrenaline enjoyment. Basically, I like getting scared. And that got me thinking. With all these movies coming out, horror movie survival must have gotten better, right?
No, it has not.
People are not learning from their stupid mistakes in cliche horror situations. And that got me thinking, I got a voice box, I can pronounce what you do. So here are the reasons why I would survive a horror movie. Reason one, virginity. Now let's be real here, banging in a horror movie is generally a bad idea, even though I won't know what it's like. I swear it's like demons have like a natural beacon to people having sex.
Bang. Bang, 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 bang,
use having sex. What do we do when we visit a creepy dark area and we're all alone?
We bang!
That's smart. Really, that's the romantic murder. Now, is it really hard keeping your pants?
Well, she wanted to do, so it's pretty hard.
Okay, well, I'll see you in your funeral later. Good job, okay, bye. As a teen, I can say losing a V-guard ain't worth getting your head or even your manhood chopped off by a machete. Just realize that you can do your business at home.
Just don't tell me about it. I don't need to hear about it.
Dos. Safety in numbers.
Oh my God!
Let me ask you, horror movie characters. Do you just want to die? It's called safety in numbers for a reason. Numbers equals safety! The villain wants you alone to pick you off one by one. If you had your friends to help the shiz out of that murderer, creepy ass doll, and the occasional satanic demon possessing a little girl,
yeah, that's it, we're going there.
Your chances of survival increase like a kabillion percent. That's not a real number. That's how confident I am. I'm making up numbers now. That's right, true shiz. Number three, don't be a wuss! I kind of question why Satan chose a little girl to put fear into our hearts. Not saying a little girl can't kill or be strong or something like that, but I think I can punt a little girl.
I shall take your house.
One, four, two, hike, boom.
Yeah, this whole video took a dark turn. Great. A doll is burnable. An elderly person is most likely fragile. And most likely you can punt a little girl. And while we're on that subject, can we please confirm the kill once we kill it? It's not that hard. You make sure you confirm it before it comes up and murders you again. It's that easy. No pulse, you're good. Pulse, stabby stabby. Number four, don't bother the possessed. If you see a figure in the room with its back turned against you and it's doing nothing but just standing there, you turn your booty cheeks in the other direction and move your caboose out of there.
Hell, you can even gyro your hips like Markiplier, I don't care.
But Thomas, what if they're just mad or really faint and need to go to the hospital?
Hospital? What hospital except Satan?
Plus, poor as hell, I can't really pay for a hospital.
Number five, don't touch demonic shits. If my friends were to ask me to join them in a Ouija board, seance, or some crap like that, you know what I'd say?
Well, your booty hole's getting possessed tonight.
Personally, I don't believe in Ouija boards or demonic items like that. But let me ask you, why dead meat? You could be watching freaking Full House or something like that. God, I love Full House so much.
Everywhere you look, everywhere there's a heart, a thing to hold on to.
Number six, no one to give up. And I do not mean your life, but what you have. If you start seeing bloody markings on the wall, and you start hearing a little girl singing nursery rhymes in a creepy tone, that's not yours anymore. It's Satan's.
It is my house. I will not stand for such a being coming in here.
Fine. Good for you. I'll be running out of the house into the car to reach another state.
Mama!
Let's call it after this bill. City of none my effing business. If you're hearing something suspicious, be suspicious! Don't be paranoid to a point where you can't move, but good lord, have some common sense! Oh, is that the sound of a murderer right here? Is that the sound of a satanic ritual? Is that the sound of a murderer's butt-stabbing death?
Oh, must be the wind.
What?
2 Markiplier references in one video. That's gotta be a record for me.
It's not hard to figure out beforehand that things are going to go bad before they get out of control. Don't be stupid and get out of there. If there is a sign of trouble pointed right at your face, you leave. You go. Go!
Are they gonna stop you from leaving? That's an immediate sign of you should go.
My hair's getting all messed up from all this. What the hell?
You know, Tom German. Life means nothing to me.
Number 8! Learn to know! This is the most important rule in my book. Why? Because you don't even need all the rules to help a sweetheart. Dark room flickering lights? Nope. Scary Woods at night? Nope. Old Billy known for its satanic rituals? No. Moving to a new house that was cheap because of the murderous things that happened beforehand? No. Sitting on my couch at home watching gaming videos on YouTube? Yes!
Oh, your couch, not my couch. I mean, you'd be robbing me and I'd have to kill your customers. What? Excuse me.
Anyway, if you just stick to that rule, you'll be safe. If you learn to get out of the situation beforehand before it starts, then yeah, you'll be cool. You'll be fine. Anyway, thank you guys so much for listening to me and my opinion on the subject. And I hope that you can use these to survive in the future. Be sure to smack that like button like it insulted your grandmother. And be sure to subscribe to see more videos. See ya! Thank you.